Good evening, Parker. Well, fortunately, across East Central Illinois, we're not dealing with the extent of flooding. They are across western portions of the state, but we still do have a few area rivers that are out of their banks. Starting off, going into Piatt County, the Sangamon River at Monticello is outside of its banks. There's a flood warning in effect for Piatt County. The flood stage is 13 feet. It's just shy of 16 feet now, expected to crest tomorrow at 16 feet. That is minor flood stage for the Sangamon River. And then as we go over into Vigo County, the Wabash River also out of its bank. Flood stage at 16.5 feet. It's just shy of 20 feet. It's expected to crest on Sunday at 21.4 feet, also in minor flood stage. So again, the rivers are out of their banks here, but we're not seeing the flooding at the extent they are across western portions of the state along the Illinois and Mississippi rivers. Unfortunately for those areas, more rain is falling. You can see this area of rainfall. Fortunately, not expected to be as heavy as we saw earlier this week, and we are at dry for now. But again, those rain showers are going to be making their way into the area through the overnight hours tonight. Right now, we're just under that cloud cover across the area. They're low-lying clouds, so not picking up here on SkyTrack. And as we look at temperatures, the clouds have kept our temperatures down into the 50s and 60s today. 58 right now in Charleston, Champaign, and Danville. 62 in Terre Haute and Robinson. Effingham and Paris are at 60 degrees this evening. So as we pick up Futurecast for the evening hours, you can see the cloud cover is going to be continuing. Once we get past the midnight hour, that we're going to start to notice those rain chances increase across the area. So mostly early Saturday morning, and then it's going to become more widespread in nature as we wake up and start our day on Saturday. So for the overnight hours, we're going to see temperatures falling down into the lower 50s under those mostly cloudy skies. Again, more rain showers on the way. Winds out of the northeast at 5 to 10 miles an hour. So picking Futurecast back up for your day on Saturday. Again, widespread rain showers in the morning hours, but as we get into the afternoon, we'll start to see those rain showers become more scattered in nature and dissipate, especially going into the evening hours. We may be able to squeeze out some sunshine across our northwestern counties for the evening hours on Saturday. Then we'll see those skies continue to clear going into Saturday night. But breaking your day down further, 53 at 9 a.m. up to 60 by noon. So it is going to be cool for any of the graduation ceremonies going on here at Eastern's campus tomorrow, and rainy in the morning, but improving as we get into the evening ceremonies, 64 degrees and with mostly cloudy skies by 6 p.m. So picking Futurecast back up Saturday night, you'll see the cloud cover on the decrease. That's as high pressure is going to be building in across the region. It'll start to dominate the area, and that'll keep us clear for the day on Sunday. So finally a break from the rain and some sunshine to go on top of that. So Sunday, a more pleasant day. Then as we get into the day on Monday, we'll see a front make its way into the area. It'll start to weaken as it moves into this region, so I've kept rain out of the forecast for the day on Monday, and we'll still see those mostly sunny skies. Taking a look at the next 7 days, temperatures are going to continue to warm up into next week. Again, 74 on Sunday, so it is going to be a very pleasant day. 77 on Monday, we're going to see temperatures continue to climb into Tuesday up to 79, and we're going to see more scattered chances for showers and thunderstorms through the day Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday before conditions start to cool back off on Friday. That's all I have for you in the Weather Center. I'm going to toss it back over to Parker.